How was your pandemic?
All sex.
This is What a Joke
with Tom Papa and Fortune Feimster
on Netflix is a joke radio.
When was your special on Netflix?
What was that? Too long ago? 2016, 2017.
So you're ready to to drop something else.
Yeah.
You know, every year I'm always sitting on all this material and I get so bored with after I've done it at all the clubs. I go, I'm going back to Kansas. Oh, I can't do the set from last year. When comedians, realistically, we get so much pressure. I always have to write. And I've always had it because of the ADD I have. So it's hard for me to concentrate on a set, let alone go rewatch my set. If I'm working on a set, like right now, or probably the thing I'm working on now, I can shoot in September. But if I get one little curveball or one distraction, it's like, or something else happens, I'm like, oh, this won't fit that special. I think every year the comics who really like love it, I think we can always, you know, put out material, but it's so many people putting out material. Yeah. So many streaming networks that you just want to make the proper decision. So I almost was deciding on going old school, back to the DVD, shoot one, sell it at only my shows, underground platinum thing.
I love that idea.
And I said, you know, or in some kind of form and let it become an underground mixtape, because we don't really have those. I started comedy, I was 19. So I have footage from almost all my shows.
VHS, oh, wow.
I just never put together. When I die, I'm gonna have all these Tupac tapes.
But I wanna be in more shit. People wanna say, why you ain't in more shit? You should be. I know. Audition for stuff. I go to auditions I know I should get. I read the breakdown. Chicago hood nigga. I'm like, oh, I'm going in for this shit. Ain't it crazy? I got to audition to be a Chicago hood nigga when I'm a Chicago hood nigga. They just give me the part. I just bring in the people I murdered. Here they go. So I go in and I audition for white people to play the hood nigga. Do you hear what I just said? Yeah. I audition for white people to be, all right, do the lines. All right, I got this. Oh, shit, I got this shit all day. Hold up. Lay on the ground, bitch, ain't a game. I wasn't scared. Were you scared? I wasn't afraid. Did you do it again? More angry, more hood. Just get in it. Get me. I want to feel, I'm going to die. I'm just a regular white guy. I'm going to die. Show me.
You got to start releasing clips because people love the stand-up clips online.
Yeah, I've been slow to TikTok and everything and slow to just giving a lot to the world when I feel like I'm so intimate with my stand-up. So I get there and you get there and this is what you get rather than just putting it out there. But if you don't, realistically, you know, the old school, hey, I saw you at a festival, let's give you a TV deal. Shit is dead. So it's time. Now you got to create your own TV shows consistent. Like what you guys do.
Yeah, for sure. We've had so many people on here that just took it upon themselves and just released something on YouTube. And it explodes. You know, it's just a lot of people get to see it.
I like how the world's going, though, because right now it's like everybody was sensitive about everything and everything's super sensitive. And now the new, I guess, going against the grain is against insensitive people. Now it's like, look at you insensitive motherfuckers. And then it's going to turn back around. And then the insensitive people are going to have a march like us, the insensitive people of America.
Oh, man.
We are being hated. There are hate crimes against insensitive people. The good thing is now they've given us so much material just to, I mean, pretty much throw away. That's inclusive of, like me, I'm a big death guy since my first special. It's just, I cannot do a special without somebody dying or talking about it. I was hurt and family members have passed, but I'm always able to flip it into like that. So I think that's the little politically incorrect thing. I think that's the depth of it I'll take. Like, oh man, wait, my cousin just died. Does he mean this? Instead of, because the person that died can't come sue you.
That's true.
Talk about all dead people, just all dead.
But that kind of stuff lasts. That's what's really great about that kind of material. It's like if you were to like just chase stuff that's happening in the moment, that's one thing. But that stuff, you can listen to it 5 years from now and it's still relevant.
Mm-hmm. I've been going up saying, let me get this 10 minutes of COVID shit out of the way.
Right.
If I don't talk about it, you gotta think I'm weird. If I do, you know. Yeah. They're like, did he not know what was going on?
And just acting like everything's been normal.
But we're 8 feet apart. I can't even touch anybody.
This is what I think part of the problem is. They're hiring police and placing them in the wrong place. This is not your area. That's why shit is happening. You can't be a policeman in the hood if you don't know nothing about the hood. It's only fair. Do a little research, know something. You can't pull me over if you don't know Migos, nigga. Got a nigga pulling the nigga over. What are you pulling me over for? What are you pulling me over for? Step on the car, don't make a sound. Sit up and down, lay on the ground. We shouldn't be scared of the police. Shouldn't be scared. Shouldn't be afraid of police. You know what I do now when I get pulled over by the police? Call the police. I'll be like, hello, yeah, there's a strange man outside my window. He has a gun. He want me to step out of the car. Oh, what'd you say? Oh, don't step out? Hey, y'all said don't step out.
You're so good at hosting. Are you going to be doing more hosting gigs? Is that a goal?
I want to. I'm hoping for Hip Hop Squares. We got picked up for Hip Hop Squares, which was a miracle. It was picked up for the fourth season. Then the pandemic hit. I can't lie, man. I was still happy because I had a pay or play. But And when they canceled it, I'm sitting with all this money feeling like, I need to host something. This doesn't feel right, God. Lord, I need to host something. You know this isn't right as we spend this money on spas. I love hosting. I love game show hosting since Mind of a Man. I love it. I've been creating shows actually with my partners, Lowy. I don't know if you know Craig Michael Lowy. He's a great writer. He was on his way to Comic Australian, but I found him when we did... Joking Off. So we did like three seasons. So I found him there and he's been working with me on a lot of taking my ideas and basically Chris Rock and Ali LaRoy in them, like putting them in the format with people who get it.
Yeah.
And we created two game shows since I've been in it for so long. Mm-hmm. I'm literally sitting there going, why? I know everything. I mean, the legalities, everything. Why not create a game show? And I created a couple of them and I just pitched to everyone, including Netflix, with Jesse Collins Entertainment, which is the producers of Hip Hop Squares and the Super Bowl. And they did the Oscars this year and they did the Grammys. So I paired with those guys on a couple of pitches so I can have my own shows rather than waiting. Because although I know that I've worked hard to be good at hosting, implementing us at the improv on Mondays into the dynamics of really having a host, I still felt like, you know, I got sat down, I got benched when this happened. And I love seeing people creating all these different platforms, like via social media and everything. That's just never been me to sit in my own room. I sometimes hate my own company. So it's like, you're trying to produce and be like, you know, I'll end up firing myself, but.
I don't want to watch this guy.
I don't know, who is this guy? DeRay, let me talk to us in the back. but I do want to create another platform, because when I did Mind of a Man, it had a platform for three comics to talk stuff, inclusive of a game show. Even on Hip Hop Squares, it includes nine people, maybe sometimes four out of the nine are comics who I could bounce off of. So I want to create more game shows where we allow comedy, like the Comics Unleashed with a game show attached to it.
It's a great idea.
That's been the creative process I've been on lately.
They do that in the UK a lot. There's like all these great panel shows and they get, and it's really just this, like you said, a setup for comedians to be funny.
We watch people do our jobs kind of a lot of times, like The Voice, any of those panel shows. We're like, there's a comic in the back having here's a joke for you. It's like, no, that guy needs to be in that seat. So that's what I want to do. More of us need to be in those seats where, cause if we were on The Voice, Forge, come on, man. We like, we don't get, yo, I like your outfit. You can't sing with the outfit. You're next, you know. So.
I know. The comics are always the one that bring the personality and fun to a lot of these things. So
So that's that's what hosting is, always a passion. Everyone's waiting on Steve Harvey to say, you want to host Family Feud for me?
I know, exactly.
That would be, that's ultimately the dream job for me. Like, I'm good on Family Feud. If I host Family Feud, I'm good. Like, I can chill. Like, I don't need to be a movie guy anymore. Although I love the movies. I love the films. I have another drama coming out. I love those because I get to, you know, I'm light skinned. I get to be tough.
not too scary.
Like on Snowfall, I get to be the murderer, but people are like, wait a minute.
It's funny.
But I think hosting is going to be the end all be all for me.
Yeah, man, yeah.
So good.
I see that.
Thank you so much.
I appreciate it. I appreciate it, guys. Much love and keep comedy alive.
That's right.
Comedy alive. Brothers and sisters.